Do you need to convert from one currency to another whenever you transfer funds between accounts? Well, then you should watch this video, QuickBooks Multi-Currency, Converting and Transferring Multi-Currency Funds. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The most common multi-currency transaction type is a transfer of funds at the moment the funds are converted to the other currency. This is because you must put some money into a bank account to open the bank account. So usually the first transaction is a transfer. Sometimes there is a fee and sometimes there is not. First example, let's imagine on March 5th we purchased 5,000 Guyanese dollars at the moment the exchange rate was 0.008 of the US dollar. That means 40 US dollars will be deducted from your US bank account at the moment of the transfer. 5,000 Guyanese dollars will appear as the balance of the account in the Bank of Guyana. $40 will be the balance in our trial balance of the Bank of Guyana. So what will be the result after this first transfer? Well, the Bank of Guyana will be stated in terms of US dollars and become $40. And because you transferred $40 out of the Chase Bank account, the Chase Bank account will be reduced by 40 US dollars and become $2,608. So how do we do the transfer? Well, it's very simple. Banking, transfer funds. Now, the date of the transfer in our example is March 5th. The funds are coming from the Chase Bank account and they're going to the Bank of Guyana. Now, they're in terms of Guyanese dollars. So first you should set the rate. And our example clearly states that the rate was 0.008 at the moment of transfer. And these will be the results. So we make sure that this is 0.08 and we make sure we're transferring on the correct date, 5,000 Guyana dollars. When we click save and close, the results are exactly as what we expected. $40 showed up as the balance of Bank of Guyana in terms of US dollars. And now in our Chase Bank account, we only have $2,608. Second example, let's imagine on March 10th, we purchased 5,000 Guyanese dollars at the moment the exchange rate was 0.009 of the US dollar. In this case, $45 will be deducted from your US bank account at the moment of the transfer. But only 5,000 Guyanese dollars will increase the balance of the account in the Bank of Guyana, making 10,000 Guyanese dollars in the account, which is now worth 85 US dollars. Now, we would enter this in the same way that we entered the previous example. However, in this case, there is a fee to convert and transfer. The fee is always recorded in terms of the currency of the account that you are transferring to. It is easy to find the amount of fee because it will be clearly deducted from the account after the transfer. So you look at the account that you transferred into, and whatever the difference is between what it is and what it should be is the amount of the fee. You will use the Write Checks window to record a fee as a separate transaction. So let's imagine this same situation as our second example, but let's imagine in this situation they deducted 200 Guyana dollars for the transfer. So what would be the result before recording the fee? Well, Bank of Guyana goes up to 85 and Chase Bank goes down to 25.63, because that's 45, or the equivalent of 45 US dollars going from Chase to Guyana. Let's take a look and see if that's what we get. So first we do this, banking transfer. And of course the date was March 10th of the second example, and the money is coming from the Chase Bank account to the Bank of Guyana. And the amount, again, in terms of Guyanese dollars is 5,000. But this time the exchange rate is 0.009 on March 10th. So we click Save and Close, and the results are what we expected they would be after only recording the transfer. Now, let's record the fee as a second example. 200 Guyanese dollars is equal to $1.80 at the moment that we made this transfer. So what will be the result? Well, the Bank of Guyana is where they took the fee from, so that will decrease by $1.80 and become $83.20. And then here, exchange and transfer fees will increase by $1.80 and become $13.80. So on the same date, you click Banking, write a check, and you're taking the money from the Bank of Guyana, and it's the same date as the transfer, March 10th. Now, we have to put the exchange rate before we put in the money amount. And the exchange rate on the date of the fee is the same as the transfer. Now, we're going to put in terms of the currency we're transferring to, because you can look at the result of the account where the money was transferred to and see how much was deducted. So it should be 200 Guyana dollars up here and 200 Guyana dollars at the bottom of the window, and the expense is exchange and transfer fees. Now when we click Save and Close, you can see the results are exactly as what we predicted. The Bank of Guyana has $83.20 worth of U.S. dollars, and the exchange and transfer fees expense is $13.80. Now, you now have in the Bank of Guyana $5,000 at 0.008, and you have another $5,000 of Guyana dollars at 0.009. So your Bank of Guyana has currency that's valued differently in the account right now. You must do a home currency adjustment before transferring the money out of the account. If you forget, then your records will not be correct and your currency units will be out of sync with the balances of the account, just like we learned in the prior video. So I think you should take a look at the video for home currency adjustment if you don't remember the reason why you must make an adjustment before transferring the money out or paying the money out. Let's make the adjustment as of March 11th, the very next day. And let's make them all equal to 0.009 so that on the day that we transfer out, we don't have a problem. And the amount of home currency adjustment gain should be $5, because it's only 0.001 times the 5,000 that went in at 0.009. So let's go ahead and adjust it. Now, what will be the results? Well, the Bank of Guyana will increase by 5 US dollars, because 5,000 out of the 10,000 units are increasing by 0.001. And the $5 actually increases down here. Did you see that? it increases the exchange gain or loss to be $5 more gain. Let's go ahead and do it. We click List, Currency List, Activities, Home Currency Adjustment. Now you must be careful of the date of the adjustment. It has to happen after all the other transactions and just for the Guyana dollar. And it remembers the most recent rate, so when we calculate the adjustment, it tells us the old balance of the Bank of Guyana, what the new balance will be in the Bank of Guyana after the adjustment, and the increase in the gain. We click the check mark to acknowledge that's the one we want to change, click Save and Close, and when we go back to the trial balance, the numbers are exactly as what we expected.